Well, I'm gonna cut some tape and apply a piece or two to the kite in areas that I think benefit a lot from reinforcement. I'm going to put a piece of tape on each end of the battens, but I think you probably know how to do that without my showing you. So I'll show you the others, which are things I found through flying that really help. I put a piece of tape that's about, oh, 3/4 of an inch long and a 1/2 inch wide, or 3/4 wide and an inch long, something like that. And I'm going to lift the kite off of the table, and I put half of this on the back, and I roll it over and put the other on the front to protect the wing tip. Now, if your flying line gets caught right in this point, just below the bow, and you don't have any reinforcement here, sometimes your flying line, because it's so thin and you're pulling hard possibly, not realizing it's tangled in the wingtip, it'll slice the skin right there. So I've had that happen, and I don't like it to happen, so I'm going to put this on to minimize it. Do it on both sides. And another place that's weak on a kite and susceptible to the skin being damaged is which we mentioned already once when we put the reinforcing for the nose up here. But I put another additional piece of tape right at the point where the nose and the bow meet, where that nose leading edge meets, and roll it over to the front side of the kite. And if you're using clear tape, or if you're using tape that's the same color as the skin material you're using, you can't even see it. Now here you can, because I'm using a white tape on purpose to make sure that you can see what I'm doing a little bit better. Next thing we want to do is protect the nose. This is an area that gets, for me at least, lots of abuse. So I cut a piece of tape about, 3/4 by 1 inch, or maybe 1¼ inches long. The sticky side is up, stuck to my finger. And the way I do this is I put this on the table, and then I lay the kite, the front face of the kite, right on the tape, a little right near the center, and then try to remove my finger and hold down the kite. Then what I do is make a cut. I use either an X-Acto knife or razor blade, and I make a cut that's let's see if I can show it to you here. Starts at the nose and goes at an angle out towards the corner, not exactly at the corner, but near the corner of the piece of tape. Now you're cutting on the sticky side, and I use my little tool to lift the tape up, and I take one part of it that was on one side of the cut and burnish it down up over the spine, and do the same on the other side. So there's actually end up with 3 sections of this piece of tape, and sometimes it's a little tricky to get it so that it'll work, and you might have to do it more than once your first go around. Then I fold the other piece over, which is triangular shaped, and fold it over like this. This gives a lot of protection to the nose. It's one piece of tape, not a lot of weight, and we're ready to go. The next part of the process is to make the bridle and identify the connection points for the bridle. What I do is place a ruler so that it lines up to the center. One of the marks here lines up to the center, of the spine, and I want of this kite to mark it on at an inch and a quarter on either side of the spine. I use that as my bridle distance. Whoops, inch and a quarter, not inch and three quarters. So I mark it on the bow itself with a silver pin, and then I also mark it below the bow and above the bow on the back side of the skin. This tells me where I want to put my reinforcing tape for the bridle holes. I cut a piece of tape about inch by half inch and use a toothpick because it's easier. I stick it to the tip of a toothpick and sticky side down, I lift the bow up and slide the tape, the non-sticky part of the tape, up against the bow, and then lay the tape onto the kite skin, covering the marks that I made on the skin of the bridle location. And this will give reinforcement when we cut the holes in the skin and through the tape as well to make the bridle holes. The other place we want to reinforce is the location of the bridle at the lower portion of the kite. And on this kite, that's located 6 inches from the spine of the kite. Now usually what I do is I'll balance the kite first. Find out where the balance point is on the kite fore and aft. I just stick my finger underneath the kite and let it balance. And once I find that location, I put my finger on the top part of it above my lower finger, and then I make a mark with my Sharpie. And from there, I measure to the bow spine connection. In this case, it's 5 1/4. And I then measure down 5 1/4 and put a mark, and that's where I put my lower bridle connection point. That way I'm looking at the bridle at these two points, and here's the balance point of the kite right in between them. Now I've also found by putting it up a little bit closer to the nose, it works really well too, and in this case I'm going to put it there. See how I like it on this particular kite. Maybe I'll put it halfway there between there. Okay, so we have tape there to protect the hole when we cut it, and we have tape here to protect that. We've reinforced the wing tips, the corners where the bow and the nose leading edge meet. And overall, the kite looks, you know, pretty close to being a kite.